Welcome to Pacific Update, our weekly news roundup for the region. Coming up, the weighty issue of airline passengers on the scales and the sounds of Melanesia. But first, in Tonga, Princess Melesiu Elikutapu Kalaniuvalu Fotofili has been laid to rest at the Mala'i Kula Royal Tombs. She was the first elected female parliamentarian in the kingdom from 1975 to 77 and was known for her service to the people. First cousin to King Tupou VI, Princess Siu Elikutapu accepted the Dawn Raid's apology from the New Zealand government in 2021. She died in Auckland Hospital, surrounded by family. Fiji's Prime Minister Siriveni Rambuka has focused on climate change and regionalism in a trip to Samoa and a state visit to New Zealand. In his first official trip since being elected Prime Minister late last year, he was formally welcomed in Wellington at Parliament House. He met with New Zealand Prime Minister Chris Hipkins, with trade high on the agenda. While in Auckland, he also met with the New Zealand-Fiji Business Council. Mr. Rambuka said geopolitical rivalries is a reality for the Pacific.
Militarization is the result of a failure of diplomacy. There is no need for us to fear any militarization of the relationships that we have in the region.
Both prime ministers agreeing to strengthen their partnership. Back in Fiji, former Prime Minister Frank Bainimarama's Fiji First Party remains suspended from Parliament for failing to submit its audited accounts and source of funds to the Elections Office. The party has until July the 15th to hand in their accounts or it will be deregistered. In Samoa, direct flights from China have begun. Six flights have so far been lined up, each expected to bring in more than 200 tourists. The visitors are spread out over a number of properties, and there are tours to attractions, including a one-day trip to Savai'i. It was estimated the first flight brought in just over a million tala to the country. A number of airlines are conducting passenger weight surveys on board their flights. Hawaiian Airlines will be weighing passengers between Honolulu and American Samoa. And Air New Zealand is hoping to weigh more than 10,000 travellers up until July the 2nd. In Niue, equipment to upgrade the island's airport runway has arrived by sea. The Cronus barge and Capricorn Alpha Ocean going tug brought in the asphalt plant and other equipment. The wharf was closed while the barge was offloaded. A Micronesian-flagged fuel tanker is stranded in Noro in the Solomon Islands after being found unsafe. The Solomon Islands Maritime Authority has found the Kaiko Maru has major deficiencies, including defects in the hull structure, and is believed to hold fraudulent safety certificates. The vessel has been used to fuel foreign fishing boats. And stunning scenes have emerged from the traditional canoe Hokulea. Navigator Nainoa Thompson shared the historical moment the Hokulea sailed into Alaska, the farthest north she has ever been.
So we're just honoured to be here.
Now to some music. Have a listen to these sounds from the Solomon Islands. Hard to beat. And still on the topic of music, American Idol winner Iam Tongi, of Tongan Samoan descent, got a wonderful welcome when he returned back to his Hawaii home. And check out the Samoan team at the CrossFit Games Oceania semi-final. These guys won the hearts of the crowd in Australia. Top athletes from around the world will be taking a series of events to prove themselves the fittest on earth. Now to our social media vids of the week. Anyone lost a boat? Look no further. And still on the roads, rush hour traffic is annoying. Moving very slowly. What goes up must come down, and at quite a fast rate too. Too cool for school, this guy. Our very own Fijian hero. Well, that's it for another week. Stay safe, and I'll be back next Friday with another Pacific update.